Okay, so to our next question, Matthew C, how do you have login user-based queries, i.e., user login and only see their records? Okay, so obviously it's something that's going to come up, isn't it? So here, for instance, I have here my grid, and in this case, I could come here to SQL, and I would more than likely need to have some reference to the user in here along the way, which I don't have. So let's find maybe or create a new application where we maybe have some user information. So if I go here, customers, for instance, okay, so let's create that. So I'm creating a grid and the form again. Okay, and here, for instance, okay, I'm reading the questions and I okay, so I'll log in. All right, so with this, we want to then define, so only, say for instance here, customer ID X99 can view these fields. So we just take here the customer ID from customers, and this is the simplest way where customer ID equals then the var global variable that you're going to have, and that will then be the customer ID. Okay, and that is really the simplest way to do it. But of course, that would mean this grid would only be usable by those users, and maybe that is not something that you want to do. So you can dynamically adjust this also. So I'm going to show you that also because that is really cool. Okay, so instead of having a grid for your users, a grid for your admin users, a grid for anybody that's using it, you can actually dynamically generate that content. So with your default select, you would then basically come here to your events, and we have here the on script init. And I think it's actually on application init I'm going to be needing, but we are going to see that in a moment. Okay, so the first thing I need to do here is use a macro. And what I'm going to do is I'm actually just going to come here to the manual and come up here to the top of this. Now, this is definitely my favorite page. I spent a ton of time here. And really, if you're using Scriptcase, you also want to spend a ton of time here because you have a lot of macros here that allow you to do some really awesome things within Scriptcase. Okay, so we have here, first of all, various macros that would allow us to dynamically adjust our content. So we have here scwhereorig, scwherecurrent. We could also change here the connection. So we're actually getting that data or that user data or whatever it is you want to do from a different connection even. Okay, so all of that is also possible, and well, it's quite easy to apply as well. So I'm just going to make sure there's no others here that I can think of. No, I think that's good. So if I come in here, we have here the scwhereorig. Now this macro saves the application's original where clause. Okay, so this can come handy. I'm not going to use it now, but this can come in handy. Okay, so do check that one out, especially when you're dynamically wanting to adjust your content. Did I? Oh, I did the where and the current. Okay, so this is, yeah, so this is pretty much the same thing. Again, where the current is and where the original is. So you may want to use that when you dynamically adjust. I'm not actually finding it now, but I do have it here within my snippets, don't I? And no, I don't have it in here. These are not my snippets. Well, I'm going to find the macro SE where SQ select, select SE select, SE select where. No, that's not it. See, I'm losing my mind today. It is 40 degrees in Portugal today, by the way. So here, we're not losing my mind at all. That is exactly what I wanted. scwhere select. And here, for instance, if we use this here within our grid, okay, so here we're saying if it's empty, and you can apply your global variable here, for instance. So if there's no user, well, then maybe you want to add a where statement, your field is then less than. So here, for instance, you would say then equals maybe your group ID. Okay. So there you would say, if it's this group, then we're going to do that. And if it's not, then maybe you don't want the via the group, maybe you then want via the user. So if I adjust these, so that makes a little more sense. And there we then have that, like so. Okay. So like that, you would then dynamically adjust your main SQL select for the grid application. Okay, so for the form, yeah, it's not as easy as that. You may want to create a separate form for those users, depending. Okay, because of course you can dynamically hide and display your fields, which would then essentially provide you the same functionality. But otherwise, for hardware, you would apply that here within the SQL statement for the form. So here you would then say customer ID, for instance, equals then the global variable that you have, user ID, for instance. Okay. And then that is then how you would apply that for the form. But again, that would then mean that it would then be dedicated for a user ID or customer ID in this case. Okay. So in some scenarios, you may want to create a separate form for those users. And again, using the events as well as the links and the action bar, you can redirect the user depending on if a X variable is available or whatever functionality you want. So when you really look at this, this is probably one of the most powerful features of Scriptcase, I have to say, because yeah, it really opens up a lot of alleyways for you to develop your applications. So do check that out. And that is pretty much what you then want to apply there.